But I did want to address this whole issue of what happens in a world where we get out of the neoclassical, the standard neoclassical assumption, right? I'm going to maintain the elastic supply of capital, but I'm going to get away from the assumptions that generate a constant share for capital and constant share for labor. In particular, I'm going to skew things in a direction that makes capital shares grow. I'm going to have delta V be negative, so technological bias and progress is biased against labor. That's going to make capital share grow.
Right.
And secondly, I'm going to make the elasticity of substitution between capital and labor bigger than one, which is going to tend to push us toward a growing capital relative to labor in the long run. And the key point, though, is the effect of capital deepening, which is even stronger in that case, right? The capital deepening effect is now bigger than it was in the standard model, still goes the same way. It still favors labor. It's still the process by which the benefits at the end of the day be competed back to labor, but it actually has the end result that capital share grows even more than it would otherwise. It's a very different view of the world, I think. It's a very different view of the world because it sort of says, oh yeah, what will happen if we allow the investment response that would naturally happen from an increase in the return of capital? The answer is capital share will go up even more. But having capital share go up even more isn't necessarily a bad thing from the point of view of workers. They'd be getting a smaller share, but they'd be getting more in total.
Right, so why should we care about capital share? We only, at the end of the day, I think we only care about the wage, right? We only care.
You're in my boat, man. That's just the boat I'm sailing on. You're on the boat with me. Other people seem to really care. Now, you might say, well, capital share can matter for something. But again, the thing you always have to remember when you look at a share is LW, or relative share, think of capital, as LW over RK. And if you tell me capital is getting more without telling me how, I don't know what to make of it. If they're getting more because R is going up, well, I know more growth than R has to be less balanced growth than W holding technology fixed. There's just no two ways about it, right? Holding the growth in technology fixed, we got this teeter-totter between R and W. On the other hand, growth in K definitely is going to be a good thing for labor, right? In terms of my picture, we're going to move from here to here. Labor's going to get all the rest of it. I mean, that's what's going to happen as K grows.